Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing my favorite backpack, the Osprey Farpoint 40. So there's a lot of reasons why I love the Farpoint 40. It's small, it's sleek, it doesn't stand out too much in touristy areas. It looks like an oversized big black backpack, which I love about it. The bag itself is about under 3 pounds. The bag comes with a real suspension system, which you don't get in a lot of bags. This means you're gonna get a full waist belt and adjustable shoulder straps. The bag is made for travel. It's not a hiking backpack. The Osprey specifically designed the Farpoint series for travel, and that's why I think a lot of people tend to go towards this one other than hiking backpacks. It has a clamshell opening design, which makes putting things in and out very easy. Now, I know there's a lot of backpacks that have that, but the Osprey has a lot of features that I like. The main thing that I want to talk about in this video is the size. The size of the bag is 40 liters. The Farpoint bags come in 3 different sizes. You have the 40 liter, which I have, the 55 liter, and the 70 liter. The 55 liter actually has an internal capacity of 40 liters as well, but it comes with a 15 liter detachable day pack. The dimensions on the internal bag are a bit different too, so you want to check carry-on sizes on airplanes before you go and the dimensions of the backpack. If you go to Osprey's website, they have all their dimensions of their backpack and it's great. So the 70 liter has, I think, 55 liters of internal capacity, but I'm not too sure on that, so do your research before you go. This video is mainly on the 40 liter. So one of the great things about the Farpoint backpack series is you have adjustable shoulder straps and you have an adjustable waist strap. This is gonna carry your load very well, and it's a very comfortable backpack to wear. It comes in 2 different sizes, small to medium and medium to large. I went with the medium to the large because I just felt like it fit better, but that's all personal preference. It's also priced competitively. Here in Canada, I think I only paid $210 with it, and Osprey had a deal going on as well. So I got a two liter bladder pouch thing, and it was like a $50 pouch for free. I'm not really gonna use it or bring it with me on my travels, but for hiking and stuff, it's still a nice thing to have. And so the other nice thing about the bag is it has a carrying handle and the backpack straps zip away. So this makes it kind of like a mini suitcase, really, in a way. And it's great for if you're on trains or when you're throwing in your overhead compartment in the airplane. This is one of my favorite features of the bag, and it just makes it super sleek and compact for when you're traveling. You can carry it onto an airplane. You do not have to check the bag. When you're trying to be minimalistic in your travels, which I tend to do, this is a great thing. This means that you're gonna have more mobility. You don't have to wait for your checked bags once you're done, and you don't have to pay the ridiculous fees. If you're flying within Europe on budget airlines, if you have to check a bag, it costs between 20 to 30 euros. Now, this is a big hit. So how do you pack so much shit in such a little bag? Well, you have to be smart about it. For me, I bring my laptop, my camera gear, about 5 shirts, 3 to 5 pairs of underwear, 5 pairs of socks, 1 pair of pants, and a pair of shorts that I could swim in and run in or just whatever. If you're going to Europe, most people don't wear shorts anyways, but I still like to have a pair of shorts, so it's nice to have. Well, the nice thing about the small carry-on bag is that you won't pack shit that you don't need. It is so easy to pack toiletries that are bulky and just all this stuff that you don't need. This really makes you strap down. So the less weight's gonna be nice too. When you're in urban cities doing a lot of walking, and say, you know, you're off at a train station, you have to walk a half an hour to a hostel or something, this is gonna be amazing for your back. This bag in general, it distributes the weight very nicely on your hips, so it is very comfortable to wear. Any other bag that has a good suspension system is gonna do the same, but if you have a small bag, you're gonna have less weight in the long run. And you need to have under 22 pounds for the carry-on capacity anyways. So I mean, this is just really gonna make your travels a lot easier and a lot more, and it's gonna make you more mobile. Also, don't stick out as much. This means when you're in touristy areas walking around with your backpack, you could look like you're just a university student with a big bag. Obviously, people are probably gonna peg you for a tourist from what you're wearing, depending on how you travel. But I just think this bag looks a lot better than some bulky hiking backpack. Obviously with the hip belt and stuff, it doesn't look exactly like a normal backpack, but I think it is a lot more sleek and minimalistic than a lot of the different wacky hiking bags you see people wear. Deuter. So yeah, I hope this video has helped you guys with choosing your backpack. I mean, it's a really daunting process, and I've done a lot of research to get the bag that I want and to get it work the way I want. It's not easy traveling on little gear. I mean, you have to get used to it, but it really is a lot easier on your mind, and it's a lot less stressful. It's a lot less stress on your body. It's just a better process overall. I'm gonna be putting a full blog post on the website about this as well. So have a happy holidays and safe travels.